Thousands of passengers had no option but to walk or take a taxi as tram drivers stopped service for 4 hours. The stop work is part of industrial action, but it's passengers who are dealing with the fallout. Laura Turner has more.
On the warpath for better pay and conditions.
This is the last stop.
Commuters steered off track to make a point.
That's it, we're done.
Trams grinding to a halt, causing chaos.
No trams at all.
So no trams today?
No trams until 2 o'clock.
Two? What are we going to do till two?
The confused forced into cabs.
I just need to go to Collins Street for his childcare, but yeah.
So you're running late now?
Yes, very late.
And drivers hoping to benefit.
Fingers crossed.
And at 9:58 a.m. on the last tram to the tennis, it was game on to get there.
You have 2 minutes
and we better get there. Can I just tell you this because I don't want to walk?
Free tennis shuttles helped, but the fight between the Rail Tram and Bus Union and Yarra Trams rolls on.
This has been going on since March, the union demanding a 6% annual pay rise and better conditions for workers. It's likely today won't be the end of strike action.
Ultimately, they're going to try and save money, and that's all it is for these private operators.
The union accusing the Transport Minister, who spent the eve of industrial action at the tennis, of being asleep at the wheel.
I would encourage both parties to sit down and resolve their differences.
The sticking point, Yarra Trams wanting to lift the cap on part-time work.
So we don't understand why the union doesn't want to discuss part-time.
More tram strikes are planned for Thursday. Hopefully, people like Giuseppe have been notified.
They're on strike.
SAG?
Yeah.
Well, Laura joins me now. Laura, it's not just trams affected, is it?
It's not. V-line passengers will feel the pain tomorrow, Pete. There will be no trains for 24 hours on the Geelong and Warrnambool lines. Passengers told to catch coaches and expect delays. This is because of more industrial action between the union, drivers and V-Line. Here's the V-Line CEO.
So far, those talks have been very productive, which is why, one of the reasons why we're so disappointed and surprised that the union are taking this action.
Now, it's not a dispute over pay, but more so over work conditions and protecting them. So, sadly, Pete, the commuter chaos continues.